Hi, Sophie here. I recently made this artwork, and after a frustrating amount of time spent trying to make 3D whiskers with grease pencil, I turned to geometry nodes instead. So here's my node setup for making 3D whiskers. I'll be using this 3D model as my base for this new version. So my starter and final blend files will be free, linked below, and I will dive right in with the geometry nodes. In this case, I have different mesh objects because I don't really know what I'm doing. So I will just select the part of my piece that I want to add whiskers to. In this case, that's the muzzle object, and then give it geometry nodes. So I'll add a distribute points on faces node to turn this mesh into points. And I also want to add a join geometry node because I still want to see both my mesh geometry and what I'm adding to it. And then after the distribute points on faces node, I'll add an instance on points node. Just to figure out the node setup, I found it helpful to start by using a mesh line as my instances because this sort of look with the lines all going upwards is definitely not what I want. What's cool that I learned is that you can use the rotation value of the distribute points on faces node, plug that into the rotation of the instance on points node. Oh gosh. For lines, instances that radiate out from your mesh. In order to limit where these lines show up and to have them be just at the whisker beds, I'll use a node group that I learned from this video from Arendale. It was so helpful, and so it's at this timestamp specifically that I'm referencing for this part of my process. And so I've mostly just been copy-pasting this node group between my files as I've used it. It's so helpful. But definitely I recommend checking out that video, that part of it, for a better explanation than I can currently offer as to how exactly this works. But the result is that I can add empties, like so. Position them to the part of my piece where I want the whiskers to show up. Let's say that's this side of the muzzle here. Then back in my geometry node setup, I'll drag this new empty into my scene. Plug this geometry into an instance to points node. From this node to a geometry proximity node, which I can set to points. And then the distance we bring to a compare node, which is set to equal. And that result can be plugged into the selection of the instance on points node. All right, and then as the final steps, the object info node here, which was the empty dragged into our scene, I need to set it to relative and as instance. And now I can raise the density to see a bit more of what's happening. So we can see that all of these lines, our whiskers, are radiating out from this point of my mesh. So I can increase and decrease the radius of this area using this epsilon value of the equal node. And then to do both of the whiskers, I can just duplicate this empty, move it to the other side of my scene, add this node as well to my geometry node scene, and then use a join geometry node to combine these two, relative as instance. And we can see as I move the empties in 3D space, it's also accordingly moving these whiskers. All right, now that this is set up, I can turn these whiskers into things that look more like whiskers. So now, rather than this mesh line, I will add a quadratic Bezier curve as my instances. But I don't want bangs or whatever is happening right now. So it seems like to have this curve match the mesh line that I had originally, I just want to give every value 0 except for the Z value of the end point. And like this matches what we had with the mesh lines. And then to turn this into a nice curve shape, I was able to do this by modifying the Y and Z values of both the middle and end points. All right, let's just say something like this, I guess. But yeah, these are the only axes I touched. Basically modifying any of the start points, pretty much ruins where they start, and so they no longer read as whiskers at all. And modifying the x values, it just ruined any symmetry that these whiskers had. So yeah, now in order to see these curve objects in 3D space, they're otherwise invisible as they are, I need to add a curve to mesh node. And into the profile curve, I can add a curve circle, which allows me to give them a radius, like a very, very small radius, does the trick. After this, I can also add a set material node to create and to give these whiskers a nice white, let's say, whisker material color. And then to add a bit of variety, especially to give these some spread from front to back, I like to combine this rotation value. So I'll make a bit of room. I like to combine it with a random value node. So to combine them, I'll first add a add node, which is a vector mass node. So add to the rotation, and into this one, a random value node. So yeah, I've given all of these values just a little bit of variation and randomness. So then with this distribute points on faces node, I can modify the seed value to experiment with some different spreads for the whiskers. I can also modify the density for a different amount of the whiskers. I can still move around the empties to slightly shift the position of these whiskers, or I mean not so slightly. I can also give the empties a smaller radius for the where the whiskers will show up. That is the epsilon value of the equal node. Oh no. I'm just gonna stop here before I break it too much. And there you have little geometry nodes whiskers. So yeah, this was just a little tutorial. I was really proud of this node setup, and so I just wanted to share. I'm still a baby artist when it comes to geometry nodes, so if ever you have any suggestions of ways that I can improve my node tree or things that I can try, I really appreciate feedback like that. But thank you for watching. I hope you're doing well. I will see you again soon. Bye.